guys, it's Sam, and today I'm doing the Disney Princess book tag. And this video is being sponsored by Disney Book Group for the release of Rebel Rose by Emma Terrio. This is the first book in the Queen's Council series, which will be following Disney princesses in their original time periods as they ascend to their thrones. And each princess is being aided by a mysterious magical force that weaves throughout the series. And this first book is Belle's story, and it's taking place in 1789, right during the French Revolution as it's about to begin. So this is reimagining her story as she's having to come to terms with the fact of coming into her queendom, but also all the historical things that are going on at the same time. I do love a good historical fiction, and Belle is actually my favorite of the Disney princesses, so this sounds very interesting to see how that would be handled, because yeah, at the end of the Disney stories, it's happily ever after, we don't hear about any struggle, and obviously in the different princesses' time periods, stuff was going on, even in like a magical world, you know? So this will be an interesting take on those stories, and I am looking forward to it. So in celebration of that, I'll be doing the Disney Princess book tag. This was a tag that went around, I think, like 5 years ago, maybe, and I never did it then, so I'm not revisiting it, I'm actually doing it for the first time. So let's get into it. And in this tag, some of the questions in the original tag were named after the movies, and some were named after the princesses, so I'm just gonna change it all to the princesses' names in question. So question number one is Ariel, a character who is out of their element, or a fish out of water. So that question made me think of Sigourney from Queen of the Conquered by Cason Callender. In this book, Sigourney is stuck in the middle of all of the political conflict. She is a black woman, kind of in a position of power among the white colonizers of this area, and so she is trying to kind of balance that, but is also oppressing her own people in that way, in a way to kind of like keep power. So she's kind of a person who is stuck between both worlds and doesn't really have a place really that she feels like in either. I will leave my review for this book on the screen to give you more details about that, but she is the first character that I thought of. For two, we have Cinderella, a character who goes through a major transformation. For that, I would say Asune from the fifth season or the Broken Earth entire trilogy. We follow her through a significant part of her life and all the things that are going on in this post-apocalyptic fantasy story that is just the transformation that she goes through and the person that she becomes and has been and flourishes into is so amazing to watch, and also just like the incredible hardship that is happening throughout this book because of the environment and because of the political systems and everything else. So she is somebody who goes through a major transformation throughout the series. Number three is Snow White, a book with an eclectic cast of characters, and that would be The Gilded Wolves and also The Silvered Serpents by Roshni Chokshi. This follows multiple perspectives in 1889 Paris, and they are basically a crew of thieves, but like higher stakes thieves than that, that are going to be stealing a magical artifact for a number of reasons, but they are all very different personalities, very different skills, and they all complement each other so incredibly well. Number four, Sleeping Beauty, or Aurora, the book that puts you to sleep. I would say The Goldfinch by Donna Tartt for this. This is a book that I actually DNF'd. I think I tried to read it last year. It is a hefty book, and it is so incredibly boring, and I couldn't finish it because I was bored to tears. Then for number five, we have The Lion King, and the question is a character that went through something traumatic in their childhood, so really that would be around Simba, but this is a Disney princess tag, so should it be Nala? I don't know. But the character that came to mind here was my poor baby Fitz from The Assassin's Apprentice, or really the whole Farseer trilogy. We follow Fitz through, like, basically his entire life, and you follow him even after this first trilogy. When he's, this first trilogy ends when he's maybe, like, mid to late 20s, I want to say, and then all of her other series, every other series follows him, so we get his whole life, but I haven't read those yet. Anyway, the whole series is him being repeatedly traumatized. So it starts as him as a kid, keeps going. So yeah, this, he goes through so much pain, unlike any other, I mean, there, a lot of characters go through stuff, but like Fitz just never gets a break. So yeah, my poor baby. Question number six, Beauty and the Beast, or Belle. A beast of a book that you were intimidated by, but found the story beautiful. You know, I haven't felt truly intimidated by a book in a long while, aside from some the books that are on my shelf, a couple of them, like, maybe, like, Priory of the Orange Tree. But, I haven't read that yet. So, I would say the last book that I've truly felt intimidated by that I read, probably The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. This is a 1,000-page book. I have the UK edition that breaks it into two, but it is a beast, and now I have the second book on my shelf as well, which I am also intimidated by. I've gotten to the point where now books around, like, 500-600 pages don't really intimidate me. Now you have to get up to, like, 800 plus and I start to get scared again, so this fits it. This is not my favorite and probably won't be my favorite of the series,
But it was a solid first book, and I'm glad that I read it. I'm going to be continuing with this series.
And question number 7, which is Aladdin, but it should be Jasmine. Name a character who gets their wish granted for better or for worse. Again, Disney princess tag. It's not really about Jasmine.
You see.
For this, I would say The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss with Quoth. I've only read this first book so far, but I think that he has a lot of things that he wishes, especially at the beginning, and he ends up getting to experience some of these things, but at what cost? Like, a lot of stuff as far as, like, the school, like, he wants to go to and, like, learning magic and all this stuff, but a lot of, like, really shitty stuff that he probably wouldn't have wanted to happen. So I would say this guy got what he wished for, but was it worth it? Number 8, we have Mulan, a character who pretends to be someone or something they are not. And for that, we have Darrow from the Red Rising series. This is a science fiction series in which Darrow, our main character, is a Red who he is, like, one of the almost bottom of the cast. Is he the very bottom? I think the Reds might be the very bottom of, like, the social caste system, and he ends up infiltrating the Golds, which is the highest level, and so he has to basically get, like, a whole sci-fi transformation in order to do that, and that's the whole series in order to take down this societal system. Number 9 is Toy Story, and there's no princesses in that, silly goose. A book with characters you wish would come to life, and that is very blatantly The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. I mean, I want all the characters to come to life. I want the circus to come to life. I want this whole book to be real. And number 10, for the Disney Descendants, your favorite villain or morally ambiguous character. Whenever this question pops up in a tag, it's like, why even answer it? Because it's the same all the time. The Darkling from the Grisha trilogy by Leigh Bardugo. He's the best. He'll always be my favorite. I don't know if anyone will ever top him. That's just the way it is. And that is it for the Disney Princess book tag, so comment below, let me know your answers to some of these questions, and also check out Rebel Rose, which is out now. I have a link in my description, so go and check that out for more information. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see all of you guys soon. Bye!